Hey guys, Richard from the Plain Bagel here. I want to take a break from my more scripted and serious videos to do something a bit more entertaining and laid back. Partially because I've seen a few other YouTubers doing this idea, so I wanted to, you know, add my own spin to it. And partially because baby Henry's been keeping Papa Bagel up a little bit at night, so this will just be easier to put together. And so today, in an attempt to make a more entertaining video that's laid back, you know, with less script work and things like that, I decided I would take some time to watch some investing TikToks. This is what it's come to. Now, I actually had to download TikTok to make this video, but I have sampled the wares. You know, I have seen a few investing TikToks out there, and oh boy, it's an interesting space. It's a lot of young people flexing their wealth, you know, giving stock picks, and at times selling a course about how to make millions. And so today, my hope as a fellow finfluencer is that maybe I can add some value as someone who works in the field and has a bit more experience. Maybe, you know, I could possibly add a bit more detail to some of the explanations and steer the audience so that, you know, hopefully you guys can avoid kind of the more clickbaity and obviously the bad advice that there's a lot of on the platform. So buckle up, we'll get through this together. And yeah, let's get into it.
If this is on your For You page, welcome to Stock TikTok.
Thank you.
We don't mess around. We make money on this side of TikTok. We teach you how to trade stocks, read charts, and invest in companies like Amazon, Microsoft, Tesla, and Apple.
I'm pretty sure that's Avatar The Last Airbender music. it's hype, I'll give them that. All right, so right away, I'm pumped up to learn about how to invest in these four companies through a bunch of different videos.
I'm gonna show you guys three stocks that I used to go from $200 to $50,000. By the way, this is prop money, you best believe I'm not selling my stocks. Starting with number three,
You know, at least she's honest. I can respect that. I appreciate that.
This is AFA. It's a weed stock. I bought it at $8 a share. And with Democrats in office and legalizing marijuana, I think it still has room to grow. Stock number two is Zillow. And with interest rates being so low, a lot of people have been buying houses, which is why I assume it's skyrocketed up. But we don't expect interest rates to go back down until maybe 2023. So I think it still has room to grow too. Number one is Tesla. It's my favorite stock of all time. I have 29,000 just in Tesla because it's my favorite. I think it'll eventually hit $2,000 with all the innovation they're doing. So I think it still has room to grow. But I bought this one at $200 last year.
All right, so let's get into stock picks on TikTok. The problem with this type of content when it comes to stock picks and things like that is that obviously this is nowhere near enough information to justify a stock purchase. You know, yes, I've been given a little bit of information about kind of the more macro factors at play. I know nothing about the company that's being recommended. I don't know about their debt. I don't know about their balance sheet. I have no idea if they're making money or not. And there's just not enough here to make a decision. On top of that, one thing I think a lot of amateur investors kind of struggle with is that just because, you know, things are good and positive doesn't mean that something is a good investment. If everyone kind of agrees that a trend is occurring, you know, if we all understand that Democrats are in office and have a higher likelihood of legalizing marijuana, we all know that Tesla has done well, and we all know that real estate is booming. This is not new information, and this information will already be baked into the stock's current price. So, you know, saying this type of information doesn't give you anything to base a decision off of. So, you know, something to keep in mind is that, yes, it's positive news, but that alone might not be enough to bring the stock higher still if it's already baked into the stock's price. Also, before we continue, I do want to highlight, because it's important, that just because someone has done well with investing, especially over the past few years, does not mean that they know how to make money in the future. I'm not questioning people who, you know, are educated and have that experience, but the past few years have been very gracious to people. So using that to kind of base your judgment off of someone's skill as an investor is going to misguide you. Nice bathroom. I can almost guarantee that this guy's selling a course. You don't show your wealth, you don't show stacks of cash, nice shoes, and a hotel bathroom unless you're selling a course, unless you're trying to, you know, get those views and get those people enticed to you know, find out, how did you do it? How did you make the money? And can you teach me how to do the same? Right here. DM my Instagram to purchase course. Detective Bagel on duty. Move aside, Coffeezilla. He's a new internet detective in town.
This is how you can invest $1,000 in the stock market in 2021. Put the first 25% into electric cars. The electric car revolution is accelerating. Put 25% into internet stocks. These companies are increasingly dominating our lives. The next 25% put into AI stocks, companies that will profit directly from these new technologies. And lastly, 25% into biotech.
So again, kind of like the past TikTok, there's not any new information being presented here that justifies buying these types of stocks. On top of that, this is an incredibly risky portfolio. This goes past diversifying and is more of a gamble at this point. You know, this isn't a sound investment approach. On the one hand, focusing on technologies like electric vehicles and AI, yes, they are promising fields that most of us can agree will likely do well in the future, but there's a lot of companies in that space that will, you know, be thinned out of the crowd as time progresses and as these companies compete for dominance. And that's going to hurt a lot of investors of specific, you know, institutions. Amazon and a few other companies did very well over the decade after the dot-com crash. Many, many other companies plummeted to the ground and never recovered. And on the other hand, you know, just as an example of how high risk these spaces really are, let's talk quickly about biotech. This is an area that I think attracts a lot of beginner investors because on the one hand, usually these companies have low valuations, at least in certain areas. And on the other hand, they tend to have high profit margins. But there's kind of a reason for that. And these stocks are generally pretty high risk, again, in certain areas. The business model of a biotech company is essentially to, you know, do research and development to develop a drug or some medication, and to then file a patent and sell that drug over that time period and make a lot of money doing so. But there's kind of two problems with that business model that make it high risk. Obviously, the research might not, you know, lead to anything. It might not yield anything of promise that the business can use. And secondly, even if you do develop a drug that's successful and makes you a lot of money, what happens is when your patent for that drug expires, competitors can come in and make a generic version of that exact same drug. And for some companies, this leads to a plummet in their income. They essentially see their business model wiped out overnight as competitors come in and offer a cheaper version of that same drug. So yes, there are companies in this space that are currently making money, but the reason why some of these stocks are so cheap is because there's so much risk in terms of the continuity of their operations and their finances. So obviously putting 25% of your money into this one space is pretty risky. And I think if you looked at any kind of millionaire or you know, wealthy investor portfolio that has done well through investing, I highly doubt you'd see these high concentrations. A lot of people who have done well have done so by including the more boring sectors that are just more stable and offer, you know, profit generating businesses. Things like utilities, financials, more consumer staples and things like that. And areas that you just likely won't see many TikTok videos talking about.
You're gonna turn $100 into $1 million in 1 year just by doing this. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna teach you how to trade options in the stock market with proper risk management and trading large companies such as Apple, Microsoft, Facebook, Tesla, Amazon, and so on. No penny stocks, no small stocks. We're gonna trade large companies and we're gonna aim for 20% return every single week. In the options world, it is very doable to do it.
No, it's not. In a given week, sure. In a given day, sure, you could make 20% or more. Consistently, there's no way. And you can just do the math to see that, because if you were earning something like 1% a day, it doesn't take long to become the richest person in the world. So no, 20% a week is not a possibility. And if this guy had a way of doing that, he would not be making TikTok videos. He would just be doing it consistently because, hey, $1 million a year sounds like a pretty good salary for a full-time trading job. On top of that, while he's talking about big companies and you know, risk management and call options, options kind of turn any sound investment into a riskier bet. So, you know, yes, they can be used for risk management in more advanced strategies. That is a thing. They tend to take something like a stock, which might be a sound investment, and make it more of a gamble because options are a temporary instrument that if nothing happens while you're holding it, you lose all the money you put into it.
Here's the number one best stock to buy in January 2021. It's NIO, and here's three reasons why. NIO Day is coming up on January 9th, and not only have they increased their production by 111%, they also have a rumored partnership with Apple.
In this person's defense, I'm doing the exact same type of cherry picking in doing this as, you know, the people from earlier. So, you know, NIO might do well over the future, only time will tell. But it goes to show that, you know, focusing on the monthly stocks to buy and things like that, it's really not beneficial. The short term is so, you know, difficult to predict which way it's going to go. And timing the market is near impossible. And as we mentioned earlier, you know, focusing on information that people already know, that's already, you know, widely spread throughout the market, it's not going to earn you excessive returns.
invest your money in something that you don't know or don't completely understand. That is the quickest way to go broke. So test the water first before you go all in. And remember to educate before it's too late.
I mean, he's right. Like, he's flexing on me, but at the same time, he's giving pretty sound advice. So I can't fault him for that. Is this what it takes now? Is this what I need to do for my content? Hold on. Hey, I'm Richard from The Plain Bagel. If you want to make big bucks, don't focus on finfluencers. You need to be educated. You need to educate yourself about stock picks while doing proper research so you don't focus on stock picks from finfluencers online. If you want to make just as much money as I make. Ignore the Chinese characters on this prop money.
What's one thing that just makes you extremely upset and you can't explain why?
This. A lot of this.
The fact that we were never taught about stocks in school and that everyone just says that stocks is all about gambling.
That's fair. You know what? I'll give that guy credit. That's actually something that's bugged me a lot is, yeah, you don't learn a lot about this stuff. And unfortunately, this is why we have a lot of this stuff proliferating on these platforms, is because we weren't taught the basics. So, you know, when you have someone flashing money and, you know, kind of giving you tidbits of information that sound right, it's easy to be misguided.
So let's start off by searching stock charts on Google.
I've actually used that site. It's a simple free resource.
So for this example, I'm using Jamaya. So the first thing that I look at is the RSI. Basically, a stock is a buy when your RSI is below this 30 right here. And you don't want to buy it when it goes above that 70.
So the RSI is a real thing. The relative strength index is a momentum oscillator. And it just kind of tells you whether a stock is having momentum upwards or downwards. The formula is something like 100 minus 100 divided by 1 minus average return of up days divided by average return of down days. But the problem is that by itself, it does not tell you whether something's a buy or a sell. That's the problem with a lot of technical indicators is they're very comforting for beginners, you know, because it gives you a metric and number that will tell you, yes, now you buy or no, now you sell. But the problem is that technicals are not very reliable and there's no single indicator out there that will tell you whether now is the time to buy or not. A combination of indicators can be used at times in addition to other information to give you a sound, you know, basis for making a decision, but individually they don't mean a whole lot. So this has been Investing TikToks with The Plain Bagel. Overall, I'll rate my experience a 5 out of 10. I hope I added a little bit of value aside from just, you know, piggybacking off of these TikToks and adding commentary. And yeah, maybe we'll do this again sometime when there's more TikToks out there that I can tear to shreds and ruin people's, you know, hopes and dreams about making it big in the finfluencer space. You know, truly, this isn't intended to tear people down, but I think people need to be responsible with what they put out. It's great that young people are into investing, but, you know, don't put the cart before the horse. Before you focus on stock picks, be educated. And TikTok doesn't count as an investing education. You know, it's entertaining. There's great videos on there. It's not enough to base your investment management off of, clearly. So thank you for joining me today. And as always, be safe out there.